Okay, I'm gonna give a slight review, not a thorough review, of the Whiteduck Regatta 16 tent, bell tent, and show you a few things that I've done to help my experience with it. First off, what I did was I put down a ground tarp or ground cloth. I got it tucked up under. It's a 16 by 16. I'm gonna grab it. Come hither. It's a 16 by 16 tarp, which the tent is a 16 and a half round. So, yeah, you're gonna tuck some corners in underneath the tent or you're gonna cut it. So, I just chose to tuck them in for right now. So I added that, and the main purpose of that is not to protect just the bottom, because the inside bottom of this tent is very heavy duty. This is not a real cheapo tent, very good quality. I'll take you to the inside, show you what the bottom's like. Let me see if I can turn this camera around. Here's the inside. And I'm going to pull the stake here. You see where I've got it? I've got the tarp tucked under. And as I was saying earlier, it's not just to protect the bottom, because the bottom is a very thick tarp-like material. But it is to that when you get home or on your way home to pack up, you're not putting up a wet tent on the bottom, which usually happens. And I've been camping for probably over 35 years, and one of the best things you can do for putting up a tent is set it on a tarp, because it will block some of the cold. But the main reason is that you're not putting up a wet tent. As long as you can get your outside dried off before you pack the tent, then the bottom should be fairly dry, because the tarp protected that. But let me show you something I added with this. Look at there. Now the center pole goes up, and it's got a rubber foot at the top, and it's got a rubber foot at the bottom. And all I did was took a small table that I had, you can tell it's used, and drilled a hole saw in the center. And that rubber footing pressed right through that. And now I've got a center table that's right in the center of the tent, which is usually the place you're not going to utilize. So why not take advantage of that footprint of that pole, which ain't much. But you got a centerpiece to put stuff. And then all along the edges, you can put your cots. There's the pockets for your wallets and electronics and all that great stuff. Your doors and windows. Here's an electrical, looks like an electrical inlet port. Yes. I haven't opened, I just opened this tent up. I haven't even opened the windows. Here is the stove jack, which I've not cut the hole in that yet. There's another pocket for devices or whatever you're going to put in it and take out to the stove jack. And it's Velcroed, which I've got a stove to put in it, but I've not cut that yet. And I've got an idea for the stove jack. I've got a small stove, by the way. I don't have a very big one. Here it is. What I'm doing, this is from an older tent. I took a nylon tent and made a stove jack in it. And this is a cookie sheet off of Amazon. I think I paid about $5 or $6 for it. I don't know. I ain't remembering the price. But what I thought about doing is just taking this old stove jack and kind of sticking it up in there. And then wrapping my stovepipe through it, and then rolling the flap down over top of it, where this would actually act as a seal around my stovepipe, because I have used it on the stovepipe. You can see where it's gotten black. And I will roll, put the edge of this up under that flap where if it rains, no water get in it. So I got a few ideas. But I can say the first attempt took me a while. This is a large tent for one person. One person can do it. It took me a good hour to get it up because I added the ground cloth and I cut the hole in the table and put the table inside, and that was a trick, sliding that in the hole and then sliding it along the floor till you got the table with the legs folded in, by the way, until you got the table under the center of the floor. And then I raised the table up and folded the legs out on the pole with a pole sitting in the center. So it's doable. I think it was going to work great. There's the hitch for a lantern or whatever you want to put light there. So far I'm very impressed with this tent. I can't wait to spend the night in it. A lot of great things I'm seeing on it. I will suggest, if you buy this tent, you go to put it up, even the smaller one, completely unzip that door. Even if you can roll it back and lock it open in place, because when I tried to raise the pole, I actually lost some air. It was sucking so much air, trying to pull air into the tent. And all I did was open that center door. I didn't open the bottom or anything. And air was, you could hear it sucking in there. You can tell the good tight canvas was doing its job. And probably the waterproofing and fireproofing that's sprayed on the outside of the tent is sealing this tent. So open that door fully before you go to put up the center pole, because it is very difficult. It's sucking air. I mean, it's got a pull on it. So that's one thing I would do different, putting this tent up. But everything else, I think it's going to work all right. I've got enough here. I work with scouts, so I have enough here probably for 3 or 4 leaders to be able to come in, set their cots up, and probably a stove to do some winter camping, which I'm going to be heading to Uara here in a couple weeks. And I'm going to take this tent. So, can't wait to try it out. You're going to want to read the instructions carefully. And I just done it a while ago. I wet this tent down, like the instructions suggest. You want to do it on a dry day to where, and that, I got a stake that's pulling out, but I didn't want to go too deep with my stakes in the ground because I got a sprinkler system here. And these stakes, they are the real deal. Check this out. That is a stake that goes with this tent. I was afraid of going into my sprinkler system, but wet your tent down real good. And as the instructions say, give it time to dry. This will help seal the fibers. It causes the fibers to swell, and it helps the tent seal even better. I've just done that. Another thing I mentioned earlier about the door, having it open while you put the center pole up. When I first got the tent, these windows were completely zipped. But I'm going to tell you right now, when you take this tent down, you're going to want to open those doors so air can escape that, and leave them open, because this will also help when you put it up next time. Not only will it be pulling air from those windows, it'll be pulling from the door. So any place you can allow air to get in when you put in that center pole on this large tent will give you a little bit better success than what I had. I expect my next time that I do this, I will have learned a lot and it'll go up a lot quicker. The only thing I would suggest Whiteduck to do on this Is that electrical port right there? It would be great to have one over on this side, not far from where the stove jack is at. For the simple reason, I may take this to a electrical hookup campground and install a portable AC unit in here to be able to camp in the summer. Where I live at, it can get up in the 90s, upper 90s, and this would be almost unbearable on a canvas tent. So, yeah, I'm going to probably take and get me a portable AC unit and set it there, but it'd be great to have an electrical port here as well. That way I'm not running the drop cord all the way across to that port there. So that's the only thing I would suggest about this tent. I don't think it's a big deal, but it would be helpful. Another port wouldn't be that bad to add. I might could even make one. I really don't want to cut the tent though. Probably won't do that. I'll probably slide it in through the corner of the door or something. But anyway, I can even come through the stove jack. Yeah, it sounds like I'm out of breath, but age and fitness. I brought my stove in here to show you how it fits. It's a Guide Gear stove. And for this money I spent on this tent, I bought a fire mat to put on this tent, and it is, let me get the info off the packet. Yeah, made in China. If you order it, it'll probably stay on a boat for a few weeks out in the harbor. But it is a fire pit, fireproof mat. I think it's 36 by 36. And I typically set my stove about, I would set my stove about in that position, because this is the side where all the wood and the embers are going to be floating or falling out. And it's a Guide Gear. I think it's the medium size stove. I don't have the pipe in it yet. I've actually got a larger Vossel Zang or whatever it's called stove. I got a large one, but that's a little bit too heavy to carry camping. But I wanted to let you know that they make these fire pit mats that are excellent for protecting your floor. When you spend this kind of money on a tent, do everything you can to protect from burning holes in it. No, it won't ruin your day, but it'll found Granddaddy Longleg already got inside. Where'd you come from? No, it won't completely ruin your tent if you get an ember through the floor, but I'm just saying, protect your tent. Spend about $30 on this mat. It will help, hopefully. And we're continuing to dry the outside. And I need to open these windows up and let some of this new factory smell go out. Yes, I love it. There's three windows. Love those zippers because they work. Unlike most tents, you have to hold the beginning and the ends, the beginning and the zipper, to get it to unzip, or it'll tangle and snag on everything trying to unzip it or zip it. Unlike these heavy duty, they're just so easy. You can tell the difference. Okay, the tent has dried, so I'm going to go in here and I'm going to show you kind of in the reverse mode of how I got this table installed in the center pole. I got to get stuff off the center first. I don't know how my light is in here. I'll just throw this down here. And by the way, that's the hammer that came with it. Very nice rubber mallet. This is one I just used with my previous teepee tent I had. Oh yeah, and by the way, If you're ever going to use a stove or any type of heat device, get your carbon monoxide O2 detector. And this, I think, is only a carbon monoxide detector. My plan is hooking it in one of these holes and then hooking it up on the loop up here, because that'll be the first place that'll run out of air or oxygen is up high, and that'll give plenty of warning if carbon monoxide exists. That's my thinking. I might need to put it down lower. I don't know. I need to do some more research on it. But a O2 detector and carbon monoxide detector, I think, would be perfect in a situation like that. Whiteduck does suggest not using a heat source or flame in a tent, although they don't, you know, they put a stove jack in it for a reason. They're just wanting you to be careful and not get flames near the material of this tent, because it can catch fire. Even though this is fire, there's fire resistant chemicals in this material that I ordered with this as an option on the tent, and waterproof material chemicals in this. I believe it still can catch fire. It's not completely fireproof, so just take note of that. All right, this table, gee whiz, and I don't know, I might be able to lean my phone up here and let you see how I do this. Where am I at? I don't know if I can do this or not. No. Well, let me try. All right. So, what I do is I lift the table up. I'm going to lift it up. You probably won't get a bad video. Well, I got it leaned up against the pole like that, and then I just start folding the legs in. And I rotate it around. This is going to be a horrible video. Okay. I'll set that right there. I don't know if y'all be able to see anything on me. Okay, so that's down, drop it to the ground, and as I pick the pole up, I'm going to get all this stuff out before I drop the pole. I am going to take the center pole out first before I take the door pole out. Okay. I went around and took all the guy ropes loose except for the one at the door pole. All those are loose. I would suggest getting you one of these hammers or making you one that's got a hook on it, because you want to pull these up by the hook, not by the rope, because it will damage all your guy ropes. If you continue to do that, it will damage them. So you want to use one of something like this to pull it up. Now, to get this table out, this is kind of reverse mode of how I set it up. I kind of pick up the pole and I just walk with it. Come on. And the rubber foot is protection. Bottom of the tent. Okay. Alright. Got to the pole. Stopped. Now, I could probably lift it out, but I do want to note that that rubber foot, I had to squeeze through and get it in there, so it may be a trick getting it out. Set the phone down. Okay, the bottom foot, or both feet, I'm assuming, are put on there, maybe with a little bit of adhesive, with a little bit of work, and that will pop off. Get it out, get your table out, put it right back on, and you should be good to go. But I know you can't see what I'm doing right now, but you can hear my comments. And I'm trying to work this foot on. There we go. Alright. Throw the table out the door. Get out the door. Pick up the phone. And walk out. Okay. There we go. Can't see. All right. Come on, video. There we go. All right. There's everything kind of collapsing. And I'm going to go ahead and pull this door pole. That was just to help me get out. It is off to the side. Alright. I'm going to go around now and pull all the big stakes with my tent hammer. And I'm assuming this will go easily because I didn't put them too deep. I got to get the dirt and stuff off of them. I don't want you over there. All right. Yeah. Where are you going, Max? Yeah, he's the reason why I had to set up on this side of the fence. He's a male Jack Russell. And this would be like pee territory for him. He would christen it in a probably two or three places. So I have to keep him on that side of the fence away from the tent. Alright, let me fold this thing, and I won't get first fold. It says fold the front and the back toward the center. So I'm going to attempt to do that now. Okay, so I folded the front and the back together, and now the two sides are together, and I got a big square. And over there is the tent bag. And what I want to do is try to get this thing folded in that length. And then I'll start rolling it. Because you don't want it folded any longer than what that bag is. So I'm going to try to half this again. And then try to measure, bring my bag up to it and measure it. I may have to fold it. I'll just keep folding it till I get it in the bag. How about that? I will learn as I go. Although the directions are very descriptive. So I'm attempting to follow those. Not sure if I'm doing it right, but I'm attempting it. Okay, I have folded kind of in quarters. And I think I got the proper width now to start rolling it. I think that'll fit in the bag. And you can see the ground tarp that I had. I had shoved the corners. They don't look neat only because I shoved them under there. I probably could mark them. Do a little better job, but hey, I'm not standing in that corner that close to the edge of the tent anyway. I might have a cot to the edge of the tent, but I think that ground tarp done a really good job of protecting and keeping the floor from getting wet. All right, let's continue wrapping this bad boy up. Ta-da! It's in the bag. A little work, but it's in the bag. First thing I did is I did put the poles in the bag first. And then the rest. Oh, God. I forgot one. La-dee-da. Well, let's put it in the bag. Golly. Okay, I got it packed up. I left the two straps that go around the folded tent itself. Forgot to put them on. Which, I'm not unpacking that thing to do just that. I'll have to catch it next time I unpack it. Make sure I put this back on. I got a hand truck out here for a reason. That thing is heavy. 16 and a half foot diameter tent. I think the package weighs 90 pounds. I think. And that is heavy. This is not something you're going to want to trek too far from your vehicle. And that's what I'll be doing in a couple weeks, not far from that vehicle. And I'll be, even as close as I'll be, I'll still hand truck it over to the where I'm putting it at. But everything that went up real well, and my final review of this tent is it is awesome. My take on it so far, everything that I've touched on it has been real quality. No complaints, a few suggestions, but nothing to say no to about getting this tent. So I'm going to suggest, if you're looking at getting this tent, get it. Money well spent. But I'll take it out camping, and I'll let you know what's sleeping in it is and how it's set up and everything else. I'll add some more videos to this video to kind of give my camping review of it. This is my setup review and of the quality of it. So that's it. Thank you.